I'm Dan Hubbard, and this documentary is supposed to be about me, which I think is a little strange because I think I'm a pretty ordinary person, but my life has been pretty interesting. I joke that I should have been a Southerner, but my father was an Air Force auditor, and he caught a major industrialist who was committing fraud. And the industrialist tried to bribe my dad. My dad, being the man he is, refused the bribe, and so was given an emergency transfer to the Cleveland Naval Air Station, despite his being an Air Force officer. And so I may have been sired in the South. I was born in a little town just outside of Cleveland, and I tease that it's territory that's occupied by the Americans, because my heart and my real love is Quebec. My mother was born in France. I grew up speaking French first as my first language, and then learned English, as all immigrant children do in the United States. Dealt a lot with prejudice growing up. Not so much in my early years, where I had the good fortune of living in Cincinnati, Ohio, a very tolerant, very open community. But at age 11, we moved to Decatur, Georgia. And I really experienced the Deep South. And this was the time of the civil rights movement in the 60s. And was able to meet a lot of people and learn a lot of things. And it really gave me a passion for equality and wanting people to be treated as human beings and to have the rights to express themselves. Many times in the United States, we, to borrow the cliche, we talk the talk, but we don't walk the walk. We claim to have free speech, we claim to be open-minded, but the reality is, if you don't fit a certain style or way of living, you're marginalized. And so, very quickly, as the son of an immigrant, I realized that there were things I could and could not do in the Deep South. And this really, it hit me very badly at a young age. As a teenager, I rebelled against my society, rebelled against the constraint. I feel I've come full circle in a way, because my mom was a refugee along with my grandma, because my grandfather was killed in Spain during the Civil War. He died on the Battle of the Ebro. Technically, he's missing in action, but after 80 plus years, we don't think he's coming home now. But as a result of that, with the rising independence movement in Catalonia, I was asked by the then head of the Parti Québécois to liaise with the independence parties. And as I did so, I kind of, I got pulled in, because these are amazing people. They've been oppressed by the Spanish for over 300 years now. And to see them reassert themselves and their culture, their language, their incredible music, for me has been a real, a source of renewal. And in my late middle age, and it's just been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun working with them, and surprisingly seeing how well they're doing, and wishing them success in freeing themselves after 300 years. It may seem kind of strange for someone who works in a very simple lifestyle as a teacher, as an accountant, but underneath it, there beats the heart of a revolutionary. And I'm hoping that this country, which I love so very much, will wake up. I have hope because of the young people. I have hope that they will cast aside a lot of the conformity that my generation has adopted and really become what they're meant to be, free and loving and growing young people. This is why I want to be a teacher. I get to touch the future every day. And I'm very blessed because my students put up with me. They tolerate my eccentricities, I guess is the kindest word I can use for myself. And it's just such a joy to work with them, because with them, I renew the hope of my own youth. And things that my generation of people were unable to accomplish because of the choices that we made, I think they will. I have a great deal of confidence and a great deal of trust in the young people of today. And that's why I'm here. The truth of the matter is, the detours are what makes life interesting.